Crews made it their first priority today to get this tree removed from the Fort Sherman Chapel, Coeur d'Alene's oldest church. And just take a look at how huge this tree is. You can see the roots up from the ground here. Now, it took crews about 4 hours to get that last piece of the tree off from the side of this historic building. The community tonight and the Museum of North Idaho are hoping for the best when it comes to repairing this historic chapel.
My first thought was it looked like a tree was taking a nap on the chapel.
That's one way to put it, but in all honesty, Britt Thurman was heartbroken to see the damage to Coeur d'Alene's oldest church, the Fort Sherman Chapel.
It's really been a staple of the community since, you know, Coeur d'Alene came about, and it gets used continuously. We have groups that rent it out. It's part of the Museum of North Idaho. So to have such a beautiful historic building have damage like this, it's really heartbreaking.
Thurman is the executive director of the Museum of North Idaho, which oversees the venue. While the roots of that ponderosa pine do not run very deep, the history of the chapel it's leaning on does. It was built 140 years ago by the U.S. Army, and it is still used today for meetings, weddings, and tours.
It's like having an old friend wounded, because for years I have been giving lectures inside the building, being a local historian and a historian for the museum.
Was it heartbreaking for you?
It is. Oh, listen, when I really saw it in the paper, and then I dashed down here.
You could really tell how important this chapel is to the community by the continuous line of cars slowly going by and people crowded on the sidewalk to take photos. Thurman says the building is leaning so much they are not even able to open the front door. Now that the tree has been cleared away, they'll soon be able to assess what repairs need to be made to this historic jewel.
So we plan on taking great care of it so it can continue to be so for years and decades to come.
Now, the Museum of North Idaho maintains this historic chapel purely through donations, and they're going to need donations to help make repairs to things like this to the building. So if you would like to help, we have information on how you can do that on creme.com. Reporting in Coeur d'Alene, Amanda Rowley, Creme 2 News.